الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، ربي زدني علمًا. قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صبغة الله ومن أحسن من الله صبغة ونحن له عابدون. صدق الله العظيم. The ayah of the Quran that I have just recited to you come from Surah Al-Baqarah. This is ayah number 138. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about literally the word sibghat Allah, the color of Allah, but it basically means the natural way. The way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for us, the path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for us, has created for us, the path upon walking which we can be guided. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to all of us and saying, what do you think? Is there a better path than the path that I have given you? وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ الصِّبْغَةِ. And those who accepted, they say, وَنَحْنُ لَهُ عَابِدُونَ. That indeed, we accept this path and we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and we do not worship anybody but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This ayah, at its core, it's telling us the path to follow, which we have asked in Surah Al-Fatiha. اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, guide us upon the right path, the path of those that are blessed. And do not, help us please, do not walk on the path of those that were misguided, and they think that they're guided. In Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens up to Surah Al-Baqarah, it opens up with a very beautiful words like, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This is the book in which there is no doubt. هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This is the book in which those who want to attain taqwa, the God consciousness, we're going to find guidance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala later on in the Quran says, you want Jannah, أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. I have prepared it for those who are God conscious. And all over the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us messages after messages, things that you should do and the things that you should refrain from. And that's basically the starting point of today. We're going to look at some of the ayahs from the Quran, from the earlier ayahs in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about some good traits, at the same time talks about some bad things, that those are the things that we should refrain from. For example, when the Quran opens up, Surah Al-Fatiha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. This is exactly how a believer thinks. This is exactly how the believer must think, should think, that all praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the worlds. Everything that is in the heavens and the earth and between it, under the surface, everything belongs to Him. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا وَمَا تَحْتَ الثَّرَى. And it doesn't matter what you do, however out loud you speak, or you speak in quiet. إِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. He even knows what is inside of the secret. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. He even knows what is inside that heart, and what this person's psyche is, what this person is capable of doing and will do, each and everything. You can hide. Every individual is transparent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we say what? إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Indeed, it is you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we worship. And those are very strong words. If we pay attention, it is indeed you only who we worship. Now when you put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you really truly worship Him, وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, and it is you only that we ask help from, then it just gives strength to your iman. Then you don't bow down in front of anybody. Your strength doesn't get shaken by little things. Because وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا. Allah is enough. Allah is enough. He's the protector. ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ. He's حَيُّ الْقَيُّومِ. He's أَوَّلِ. He's آخر. He's from there and He will always be there, and things keep changing. But he's there, he's the Lord, he's Allah. And that has been the message from the beginning. If you look at the stories of Salih alayhi salam, Nuh alayhi salam, Ayyub alayhi salam, Yusuf alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, that was always the message. Worship Allah and Allah alone. And that's exactly what in the beginning of the Quran we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please guide us on the right path. Because even if somebody shows you this is the right path, you need to be guided on the right path to reach the destination. If I'm going from here to Detroit, and somebody tells me, okay, take 94. Okay, now that is showing the way. But then there is no guarantee I'll reach Detroit. So showing the way and guiding through the way to reach the destination, both help we need from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Show us the right path and help us stay on the right path so that we be guided. So, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. And if you open up, go further in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that who are the believers? الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. Those who believe in me, the things that I tell them through my Prophet, believe in me, believe in the Jannah, believe in the Nar, believe in the life after death. They believe in angels. They believe when I tell them to believe. Five senses are not important to them when I tell them to believe. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. They steadfast in the prayers and they promote the prayers. They establish the prayers. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And whatever we give them, they give it out from it. In the form of zakah, in the form of general charity. These are the believers. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ. And they are the believers of whatever has been given to you, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ. And whatever was given to the prophets before. They believe that what in the original form was given to Moses, to Jesus, to Joseph, to Abraham, to Noah, came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ وَبِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ. And they believe one day I have to return to my Lord. Now that's a very important factor. A lot of the injustices that we see around us in this world is because somebody who's committing injustice forgets that one day he or she has to answer somebody. The moment you realize that there is one day I have to be answerable to anything that I'm doing, then you stop. This realization is very important. The moment you think, this action, these words, I have to one day be answerable, you will stop. And that's why this is very important that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us as early as in Surah Al-Fatiha, Maliki Yawmiddin, one day you will gonna come in front of me. And you have to answer these things. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if you build these traits in you, these are the founding principles, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. These are the people that are guided by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. These are the people who have really truly been succeeded. So the success lies in the fact that we enter Jannah. And the people will enter Jannah only if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes so. And ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ. Or ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. This is really truly the greatest victory entering in the Jannah. All other things would not matter. When the person will enter Jannah, if it asks of this person, did you have any hardships in this world? He would say, no, I don't even remember having hardships. No, what hardships? And a person entering the hellfire, even if they'll live like a king in this world, will be asked, didn't you have a beautiful life back then? He said, beautiful, what beautiful? So this is the really, really true success lies in entering the Jannah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَبِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And then in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 21, I'm just going forward specifically to those ayahs where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about some messages for us. Do these and don't do these. So, Ya ayyuhan nas, O you all people, U'budu rabbakum, worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Alladhi khalaqakum. Now, these are two different traits. The one who created you The one who needs to be worshipped is the one who created you. He really truly deserves to be worshipped because he is the one who created you. If you ask pagans or idol worshippers, they worship so many gods. Why do they do that? Because this does this and that does that. Okay, did either of them created you? Say no. Even people of Makkah knew that, that none of these Hubul or Lat or Manat or Uzza or Isaf or Na'ila, none of them created them. They knew that. So at the back of the mind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is instilling this, that then worship the one who created you, because he is your Rabb. He's not just your Khaliq. He didn't just create you and let you go. He's your Rabb. He sustains you. He provides you means to sustain. Subhanallah, he is the one who blesses you. Now think about it. Today, it's so quiet. Why? Because a lot of the luxuries have been shut down because of the power outage. This quietness, we're not used to. Because all those luxuries that we're producing noise, are we are used to that luxury. Who gives us luxury? We didn't create it out of nothing. All this wood, where does this come from? Who produces the tree? This metal? Who produces the metal? Where did the hadith came from? The Quran has the entire chapter on hadith. The iron, the ores, the metals, the minerals. You pick any item. If you go to its core, it comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when He gives everything to sustain, then He definitely deserves to be worshipped. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Ya ayyuha al-nas, u'budu rabbakum, alladhi khalaqakum, walladhina min qablikum, and the people before you. Why? La'allakum tattaqoon, so that you become God conscious. So worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should make us more God conscious. If that's not happening, then something is not going on right. So we need to look back and say, okay, I'm praying, but it's not affecting me. That means something is not right here. I pray 5 times a day, still I'm the same person. I lie, I cheat, I backbite, I hurt other people's feelings. So something is fishy, something is not right. How is it possible that I'm asking for guidance and I come out of it, I'm still corrupt? There should be some improvement. What am I doing? Where am I going wrong? Am I doing anything between the 2 times that I'm praying, like between Fajr and Zuhr? What am I doing? What is my life like between the 2 prayers? What do I do before I go to bed? What is my night like? What is my thought process like? What are the things am I seeing? What are the things that I'm hearing? If I come to the masjid hearing rap sound and I turn it off just because I'm in the masjid's parking lot, then of course, if that's filth coming in my ears, I'm entering salah with that filth. I'm going back in my car, I'm tuning in the music, and that's I'm way off. So my mindset is being built by that filth that's coming in my ears. What am I listening? What am I seeing? Who are my friends? Who I hang out with? Are they positive people or negative people? Do they always talk about angry stuff? Because that's then all going to be a mad person then. If I'm surrounded by a bunch of angry guys, I'm surrounded by a bunch of anger, and I have negative energy that I'm constantly taking, I become a negative person. You might have seen some of these people. They don't even smile. They're like robots. And you're wondering what's wrong with these people. They have just a hard heart. And then there are people who only smile to the people that they know. If a stranger says hi to them, they're like, who are you? So, what are we? We have become the product of the societies we live in. So we have a choice of choosing the company. Are we choosing the right company or not? That decision is ours to make. Because the choice of company we decide to choose will not going to just affect us, will affect everybody that surrounds us. If I'm angry, I'm angry to my family. I'm angry to other people. So they take all this negative energy, they will going to burst out someplace else. But I'm positive. If I'm positive, if I'm nice, if I'm humble, that's exactly what I'm giving out. That's exactly the other person is receiving. That's exactly that they're going to spread. Somebody's really, really, really angry. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet tells him? Calm down. and gives them steps to calm down. Perform ablution, perform wudu, pray. If you're standing, sit down. If you're sitting, lay down. Control, calm down. Bring back that positive energy of your soul back in you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, so that you are what? God conscious. These worships should make you God conscious. Coming out of the month of Ramadan, I shouldn't be looking up to, oh my God, today's Eid. Whew, man, I can do, but go back to what I was doing before Ramadan. No. That means, what did I gain out of Ramadan? I didn't gain out of much. I should rather be looking at, okay, now moving out of Ramadan, I should now take some of these values and work on it, build on top of it. Versus just totally discard it and wait for the next year to come. So لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you are, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you, أُعِدَّتِ الْمُتَّقِينَ, the Jannah has been prepared for the people who are God conscious. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ayah number 27 of Surah Al-Baqarah says, الَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِهِ, those who have broken their covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after they came in the covenant, in the relationship of signing an agreement. And on top of that, وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ, and they broke all the ties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them to steadfast. أَن يُوصَلَ وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and as a result of all of this negativity, a facade was created on the planet. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ, these are the losers. So when I as a believer is reading these ayahs, what am I getting out of it? Things not to do. I have an agreement with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that agreement is 6-7 words. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Am I living up to that agreement? Is my life evidence of that agreement? Then I'm a loser. I have to work on it. I need to get back and read the contract again. I need to see if I'm following the basic principles of Islam. Am I praying 5 times a day? What is my prayer like? Am I paying zakah? Am I fasting? If I'm capable, am I performing the hajj? And what is it like? When I say Allahu Akbar, do I take a dream vacation after that? Till the imam says, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Peace and blessings on everybody. I'm like, oh my God, you're done? Or am I there and like, oh my God, I'm standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So subhana rabbi al-a'la. I'm saying subhana rabbi al-a'la. My God is the greatest. My God is the greatest. So I come out humble. I don't come out arrogant from the salah. Even if I'm more knowledgeable than the people that I'm surrounded by, because again, the knowledge lies with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we all get a little bit out of it. Somebody has more knowledge than the other. Nobody is all knowledgeable. وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ, Surah Yusuf. Above every knowledgeable person, there is somebody more knowledgeable. Musa alayhi salam has a set of knowledge that Khidr alayhi salam didn't, and vice versa. And Khidr alayhi salam said to the Musa alayhi salam, as reported by Hafidh ibn Kathir and Tafsir ibn Kathir, that when they were traveling in the boat, he said, Musa, your knowledge and my knowledge. Ilmi wa ilmuk. And the knowledge of everybody. You see this bird over here that drank a little bit from the water and flew away? Is not even that, if we consider this whole of the river to be the knowledge of Allah. Is not even that how much this bird drank from this water and flew away. Oh, everybody's knowledge. Because where did everybody's knowledge came from? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the source. So that humbles an individual. It doesn't matter which area we excel in. When we look at these ayahs, I'm like, oh my God, I'm Mr. Nobody. What was I created from? Nothing. Where are we going to go to? I'll be dust. Till I'm resurrected back. I have to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, who will say now, who is the king today? Who is the king today? And all the kings of this world will going to just shut. All the Firauns will shut, all the Namruds will shut. Nobody can speak. And he himself will respond, I am the king today. I only lies with him. That's why when you go to some of the shuyukh who work on your inside, do your tarbiyah, your tazkiyah to nafs, their first responsibility is to minimize that I in you. So what do? They put you in serving others. Because serving humbles you. You're serving a person which in other means is below you in economic reasons. So when you serve such a person, it humbles you. And when you serve repeatedly, it humbles you more. Serving always humbles you. And the charity should humble us. Should. But if it does or doesn't, that's our decision to make. Because all this, I don't own any of the stuff that I'm giving away. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ Whatever we give to them, they give from that. It's not us. It's not ours. Everything is His. لَهُ His. We're just giving from what He has given us. Now when you start thinking like that, the whole equation changes. But when you start thinking this is mine, then there is an I that comes in, and that's ego. And the Sibghat Allah that we talked about earlier today, the starting ayah, the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then doesn't come in. The way of Allah teaches us humbleness. Look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes the most arrogant of arrogant people will come in his presence and will talk to him in a very arrogant manner. But he wouldn't get upset about it. Because if you look at the human nature, the civilized individual will never go down to a level of an uncivilized person. Rather, the duty should be to uplift that individual. And the prophets are of the highest values in civilized world. Khuluqin azim, they are the top of the level. They are the role models to learn from. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through these ayahs is teaching us over and over again what to do, what not to do. If you move forward in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 42, again, one of the other things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about, وَلَا تَلْبِسُ الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَتَكْتُمُ الْحَقَّ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ Do not hide the truth with lies. And when you know what is lie from the truth, don't do that. Don't misguide people. Do not misguide them. Just to follow your agenda, do not change the principles of religion. Don't do that. And other than that, you should rather be guided. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةِ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ Join together. Build a community. Strengthen yourself. Leave the differences behind. وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ And come in total submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and take away these differences. How often when you're standing in salah, you care about the guy's economic status who is standing next to you? Because your sole concentration is on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's community. That's the unity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to bring in us. So these ayahs of the Qur'an, when you look at them, we look at the negatives and we say, oh, this we shouldn't do these. We look at the positives and say, okay, do I have it? If I don't, how can I build it? So that's why we need to look at these ayahs from different aspects, from different angle. Because sometimes we make these mistakes and say, oh, this is for Yahud. Oh, this is for Nasara. Oh, this is for other people. No. This is not just for them. See if you have not built those evil traits in you. That's something not to do. They did it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ Don't do that. Rather, صِبْغَةَ اللَّهِ Take the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.